Hey guys, Gregory here. Today we're going to be learning how to play Blue Christmas by Elvis Presley. I have two rhythms for you, one like what you heard in the demo at the start of the video, and one that's a bit simpler if you want something simpler. So let's take a look at it. So just two things about the song. We're going to be learning to play it with the keyboard on the second fret, so that way we avoid bar chords. Always a good thing, but not always a good thing. And then the other thing we're going to pay attention to is the type of rhythm that we have in this song. Aside from the strumming pattern, the entire song has what we call a shuffle rhythm in it. And we can think of this shuffle rhythm as a kind of bouncy feeling. So what I'm going to do is, while explaining the strumming patterns that we have, the two options we have, we can use either one. I'm going to show you what either strumming pattern sounds like with the shuffle rhythm, which is what we want, and then without it, which is what we don't want. So the first strumming pattern that I'm going to show you is actually a bit simpler than the one you saw at the start of this video. It sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Blue Christmas without you. And that is just down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Now if you've been playing guitar for a while, I'm pretty sure you would have come across this strumming pattern before, but what makes it, you know, a bit different than what you may have played before is the fact that it has a kind of bounce coming down to the end of it. So to kind of help you to distinguish what it should sound like from what it shouldn't sound like, I'm going to play the strumming pattern with the shuffle rhythm, which is what we want, and then I'm going to play it without the shuffle rhythm, which is what we don't want. So with the shuffle rhythm, like I just did, sounds like this. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, right? And without it, it sounds like this. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Okay? It's a major difference, especially when playing it with songs, with that shuffle rhythm. So we want the first one. Da, 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 ba, 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 bum, ba, da, ba, 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 right? So try to get that sound in your head. You know, replay what I just did a couple of times and try to really get it in your head, and that's when it will actually sound like what it's supposed to sound like. So the second option we have for strumming the song sounds like this. Right? Even more bouncy. Now, once again, there is that shuffle element in it, and I'm going to play it again without the shuffle feel so that you can hear the difference. So here we go. Right? With the shuffle feel. Right? So we have shuffle that goes bum, cha, cha, dum, cha, cha. And then without goes dum, cha, cha, dum, cha, cha. Right? We want that bouncy shuffle feel. So moving on now, the actual strum, to do it, we need to pay attention to the chords that we're playing. If we're playing a D major, for example, that's a chord that starts on the 4th string. So what I'm doing is I'm actually picking the 4th string as the first note. And then I'm going to strum down up. So you have pick, down, up. And then I'll hit the string that's physically above it, the 5th string. So I have 4th, down, up, 5th, down, up, and repeat. 5th, down, up, 4th, down, up, 5th, down, up. And that's it. If I have a chord that starts on the 5th string, like E7, I want to start on the 5th string. 5th string, down, up, 6th, down, up, 5th, down, up, 6th, down, up. If I have a chord that starts on the 6th string, I'm going to hit the 6th, but then the 5th. So I have 6th, down, up, 5th, down, up, 6th, down, up, 5th. Okay? So that one is a little bit in reverse in terms of the bass notes, the order of the bass notes. But that's pretty much it for the strumming pattern. Now, it's not necessarily easy to do. It may take a bit of practice to get the hang of this. And if you like it enough, you will practice it. But I'm going to offer a slightly simplified version of this particular strum. So what we can do is we can take out the ups in the strum. And then it becomes a little bit easier on your right hand. But it sounds like this. I'm going to play it on D, which starts on the 4th string. So I'm going to pick, strum, it's 4th string, down, 5th, down. If I do it on A, 5th, down, 6th, down, 5th. So sorry, fifth. Dum, sixth. Dum. If I do it on G, same thing, but starts on only sixth string. Sixth, dum, fifth, dum, sixth, dum, fifth, dum. When this trumpet pattern out to the way, let's talk about the chords that we're going to find in this song now. So I mentioned before, at least I hope I did, we're going to be playing this song with the capo on the second fret. So, the first chord that we find in the song is a D major. That's the open 4th string. It starts on the 4th string. And then we have the first finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string, middle finger on the 2nd fret 1st string, and the 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 2nd string. And we strum the 4th to the 1st for D major. The second chord we have is an A7. It starts on the open 5th string. And then we have the 1st finger on the 2nd fret 4th string, and then the middle finger on the 2nd fret 2nd string, and we strum the 5th to the 1st, that's A7. And then we have a D7 that comes, so that is the middle finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string, the 1st finger on the 1st fret 2nd string, and the 3rd finger on the 2nd fret 1st string. And this chord starts on the 4th string, so we strum the 4th to the 1st. Then we have a G that starts with the middle finger on the 3rd fret 6th string, 1st finger on the 2nd fret 5th string, 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 1st string. This chord starts on the 6th string, we strum the 6th to the 1st. And then eventually we come across an E7 chord. That's the open 6th string, the middle finger on the 2nd fret 5th string, and the 1st finger on the 1st fret 3rd string, and we strum all 6. It starts on the 6th string, if I didn't mention that already. It's E7. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to play through most of the song. The song is really just 3 verses. The 3rd verse is like a repeat of the 2nd, so I'll just play the first 2 verses. And I'm going to do it with the simplest strum. If you want a reference to the more advanced kind of bouncy strum, check out the demo at the start of the video, because I do it there, okay? Now there's maybe 1 or 2 little things to look out for. There's a type of run that I do between G and E7 in the first verse. I'll play it for you. I'll start a little sooner from the D. It goes, decorations of red on a green Christmas tree. Ba-da-da-da, da-da-da-da. But you're not here with me. Right? And then I do a little drop there. So the part with the run from G to E7, I play a full strum on G, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, and then I'm going to pick 3rd fret, 2nd fret, 1st fret, open, and then continue the strum. So once again, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, and then my middle finger is already on the 3rd fret, so I just pick that, 3rd fret, 1st finger on the 2nd fret, 1st finger again on the 1st fret, and then the open string that I pick after that counts as the first down in the strumming pattern for E7. Open, down, up, up, down, up. Okay? One last time from G to E7. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down. 3rd, 2nd, 1st. Open, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up. Let's continue. E7. And up. And then we just add a little mute there for suspense. Alright, so let's go. I'm gonna play through the first 2 verses. 1, 2. One. Oh, 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 blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorate. Thank you. I forgot to record the last part of the video, the part of the video where I say goodbye and thanks for watching. So goodbye and thanks for watching, and please like and share and subscribe because it will help me out a lot. Goodbye.